The health program, which is operating under a budget of 3.67 trillion shillings this financial year, has suffered a huge budget cut of 430.1 billion shillings in the financial year 2023-2024, according to the National Budget Framework paper. The cuts have mostly affected regional referral hospital infrastructure development by 23.8 billion shillings and non-wage budget by 75.4 billion shillings.
Present a community which shares medical, health sector with Kenya. And as leaders, we have constantly remained a laughing stock because we cannot even provide mortuary services in Uganda. Our beloved ones are kept in Kenya because of a good working relationship at the border. They die in Uganda, we take to Kenya for preservation until we bring them back for burial.
While presenting the Health Committee report on the health sector budget to the House's Budget Committee for reconsideration, Dr. Charles Ayume, the chairperson of the Health Committee, urged Parliament to reverse budget cuts if the health sector is to remain fully operational.
Committee therefore recommends that Parliament reverses this proposed cut and instead provides 23 billion under regional referral hospitals for infrastructure gaps to improve provision of healthcare to expected standards.
Committee members observed with concern that while budget cuts have cut across all programs for the next financial year, it is suicidal to allow the health sector suffer the wrath of the finance sword.
Avoid being frustrated. Both us as Parliament, you as a chairperson who is a member of Parliament, where do we draw the line? Can we look at these things and say, okay, for this financial year, given the challenges, medicine takes first priority. There should be no health center that has no medicine. We take it off.
So why do we allow Kenya, first of all, to take our money, but also to seek a treatment far away in a public facility? Because those who are going to Aga Khan, I can understand. But how can a government minister travel to be treated in a government hospital in Kenya? Me, I think listening to the story of the health sector will itself make you fall sick. In fact, the best way is not to come here next time the health committee is presenting. Because, I mean, 180 million shillings, and they are all still in the budget, people pleading for them to repair machines, 180, this.
The health committee has also recommended additional funding of the national medical stores by 87 billion shillings to mitigate the dwindling funding of development partners. National medical store is suffering funding shortfalls for laboratory reagents, ARVs, anti-malarials, TB medicine, immunization supplies, among others.
Of the 720 billion needed to in the next financial year, NMS is projected to receive 483.45 billion, leaving a funding gap of 298.5.
Still, the committee wants more 2.9 billion shillings for the General Military Hospital to mitigate gaps in the health supplies caused by the Operation Shuja, which Uganda launched against ADF rebels in Democratic Republic of Congo.
UPDF receives 4.6 billion for all its health facilities, including Operation Shuja. Is also cut from there, and their request was an extra 2.9 billion to cushion for this shortfall.
Other key priorities highlighted by the health committee is operationalization of the national ambulance system, which requires funding of 73 billion shillings. Others are provision of primary health care, which is grappling with a funding gap of 24.7 billion shillings, funding of hospital equipment with shortfall of 24.1 billion shillings, lack of critical human resource with a funding gap of 21.7 billion shillings, blood collection and mobilization facilities, which has suffered a budget cut of 2 billion shillings, among others.
Need to deploy the ambulances, but have them move in a coordinated manner, meaning setting up of regional command and dispatch centers, so that we can coordinate emergency response as opposed to ambulances operating in silos in respective districts.
The issue of expansion, one time I was in Kirudu, even in the other place, Kawempe. At times you fail where to park and you park outside. So that one, I think Kametoa has to look into it.
The committee has, however, rejected a request of 6 billion shillings by the Minister of Health to procure vehicles for senior consultants.
Someone you pay 20, 18 million shillings. Why do you buy that person a vehicle?
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.